into turn four and they get the signal to show you the most awesome sight in all of motorsports. The very best that sprint car racing has to offer, four wide on display here this evening. This is the driver's salute. And ladies and gentlemen, in return, we want you to stand and we want you to make some noise. Show your appreciation for their efforts here this entire weekend. Eldora Speedway, you wanted the best, you got them four abreast. Often imitated, never duplicated, the greatest show on dirt, the World of Outlaws STP Sprint Cars.
Momentum up high. Shots now all over Brian Brown into turns three and four. Brown goes to the bottom. Shots runs the high side. Darren Pittman down low. Shots with a run on Brian Brown down the front stretch into turn one. Slide job into turn two. Brown powers back around him. Shots stays right with him down the back stretch into three and four again. Shots to the bottom of the speedway. Brian Brown on the cushion. Donnie Shots down low. They battle for the lead. Brown has it out of turn four. Last night tonight. We had a first time Eldora Speedway winner. Can we have a second one here tonight? 9 laps away from his first Eldora win and his first World of Outlaws win would be Brian Brown. Brown now into traffic, just about into traffic, I should say, into turn 3 and 4 as Tim Schaefer and Craig Kinsler race side by side directly in front of the Casey's General Stores number 21. That time by a 1.1 second lead for Brian Brown over Donnie Schatz. Tim Schaefer off the pace on the backstretch, headed to the infield. Caution flag waves. Caution flag waving. Car spinning in turn 4. Back to green. Darren Pittman gets a tight restart. Goes by Schatz, goes by Brown. New race leader Darren Pittman in turn 2. Pittman got a great restart on the bottom and got by Brian Brown and Donnie Schatz. Now Brown back to the inside of Pittman, but no good. Darren Pittman leads lap number 23. Pittman is gone. Donnie Schatz gets by Brian Brown for second. Can he have enough time left to track down the number 9 car? Now Brown back to the inside of Schatz for second. They race side by side and Darren Pittman pulls away. Schatz to the inside of Brian Brown once again racing for second. Schatz is clearly faster, but Brian Brown is blocking. Pittman from the 7th starting spot. A late race restart and he is absolutely gone. The Great Clips number 9, a rocket ship around the Eldora Speedway with 3 laps remaining. Brian Brown holding on to the second spot now and actually pulling away from Donnie Schatz. Schatz runs third, Jack Hodge, Jill Ford, Joey Salamana fifth, Paul McMahon sixth, Steve Kitcher seventh, Cody Darragh eighth, Chad Kemenaugh in ninth, Sammy Swindell 10th. Pittman out of turn 2, down the back stretch. Into 3 and 4 for the final time, Darren Pittman caps off the weekend with the Eldora victory in the Great Clips number 9. Brian Brown finishes second, Donnie Schatz in third, Jack Hodenshield fourth, and Joey Saldana in fifth.
The Great Clips number 9 roll into victory lane at Eldora Speedway. Happy night for this crew. Sage group, ASC, a lot of great people involved. In the Casey K machine, Darren Pittman, the Oklahoman struck again. What a night and what a run. Great racing throughout the field, Johnny, and this is going to be a big party night for the guys with this number 9.
A feature for the UMP Dirt Car Modifieds. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, it is showtime. Side by side off into 1 and 2, the steel driver, John Henry, will power ahead into the early race lead. Brandon Vaughn going to try to tuck in line in the second spot. Last week's winner, Brian Post, runs third. Coming out of turn number 4, that's how they are at the end of lap number 1. John Henry, Brandon Vaughn, Brian Post, your top 3 cars. Here comes Bowersock now. Dive bomb to the inside of Brian Post off the nose. Post back down to the inside with a crossover move. Post had third that time by at the stripe. Bowersock, slide job. Doesn't net him the third position. Post able to grab it back. Here comes Bowersock backing into the inside at 3 and 4. Another slider. He washes up the track. Brian Post back down to the inside. Slide job into slide job for the third position. Post on the bottom, Bowersock on the top. Bowersock gets it finally. 5 laps in the books, 13 laps remaining. 1/3 of the way through this one. And Bowersock now gonna dive bomb Brandon Vaughn into 3 and 4. Vaughn dives back down to the inside at the stripe. Give it to the Jedi. Bowersock pushing the Army's Auto.com number 5X up into the Bridesmaid Honors. Brian Post looking to follow suit. Post gets a run on Brandon Vaughn down the back straightaway. Post moves down to the inside. He'll pull the 45 into third. Vaughn now going to have to settle for fourth. Trouble over in 3 and 4. The 188 of Aaron Orr spins on his own in 3 and 4. Caution flag is out. Green flag is out. And Henry, like he was shot out of a rocket ship, barrels off into the lead, and there's a hornet's nest of cars battling back there behind of him. 3 wide on back for about the 6th spot. Jerry Bowersock, though, in second, turning away the challenges of Brent Ryan Post. Post grabs the Eldora car in 3 and 4. He loses 5, 6,
seven, eight spots, nine spots. A top break for Brian Post. That moves Brayden Vaughn to the 36, back up to third. Three laps remaining. And we'll have to see if lap traffic is going to be a factor, as John Henry is quickly closing in on the back of the field. The first car to go one lap down would be the 79 of Shane Unger. And Henry just lost power. Your race leader, John Henry, just lost power coming off turn number four, two laps from the finish, and now power gathers back up. It's almost like the car shut down on him that allowed Jerry Bowersock to get by. And the yellow flag is out for trouble over in turns three and four. It's the 15 of Nick Catter Henry. So Catter Henry gets into the wall, and we'll have to see if that was a fully completed lap. If that was a completed lap, your race leader will be the 5X of Jerry Bowersock. If it wasn't a completed lap, they'll revert back to lap number 15, in which the 23J of John Henry was out front. Just two laps remaining, two laps to go in the A feature for the UMP Dirt Car Modifieds. Green is back out. Henry leads the long conga line of cars off into turns one and two. Brent Hull trying to work his way up through the field. He's to the inside of Scotty Williams in a battle for the fifth spot. Hull in the zero, Williams in the one. White flag in the air this time by for your race leader, John Henry. And trouble in turns three and four. Mike Dirksen goes around. He gathers up the 52 of Weasel Flippo, and that'll put us under caution one more time. Green flag is back out. John Henry in the 23J leads him off into one and two. Bowersock in the 5X gets a nice run down the back straightaway. Bowersock gonna dive bomb that car into three and four. Here comes the Jedi. White flag is out, final time around. Who's it gonna be? Henry trying to hold on and pick up his first Eldora win in a couple years. Bowersock gonna give it one last go this time by. Don't know if he's got enough. Into turns three and four, Bowersock hard into the bottom, but it's not enough. Off corner number four, the winner tonight, the 23J of John Henry. Out of Ada, Ohio, ladies and gentlemen, the steel driver, John Henry.
And as you look in the cockpit, that man has swung the silver hammer tonight, John Henry, with a big win at Eldora Speedway, a big weekend. He's out of the car. There he is, your winner. And the open wheel modified feature event here at Eldora Speedway, John Henry.